Radhika, welcome to the show. I think it's so fitting that you're on this show that we're calling the Bold Bunch because you've broken the rules, you've led your career the way that you want to. I thought I'd start by saying, you know, Radhika, I feel like you're having a lot of fun in your career. You're having a lot of fun as an actor. You're mixing up your choices. You're unwilling to be boxed. You're really creating your own rules. You make the smart indies. You do the occasional, not the occasional actually, more and more you're doing the mainstream films, whether it's an Andhadhun, whether it's a Bazaar. You make the regional films. You continue to work in regional languages. Most recently with Rajni sir, you've done these incredible cutting edge shows, Sacred Games, Ghoul. There's the international projects when something exciting comes along. Most recently, of course, Michael Winterbottom's film, The Wedding Guest. What's driving your choices, Radhika? Is there a plan? Is it purely from instinct? Are you just trying to make sure you don't get bored? What's driving the choices?
I think it's instinct. I think trying not to get bored. I mean, that's also instinctive, right? I think I'm just trying to find work which makes me excited or which makes me want to like lose sleep in a good way.
Right.
You know, and get like just, I can't wait to shoot that film or I, you know, I feel. But if that a film doesn't do that to me, at this moment I've reached my level where I go like, then I don't want to do it. At least now, because I've had last 3 years, 4 years, I've worked a lot. And I've reached a point where I don't mind chilling over doing something that I'm not entirely convinced about. Suddenly last year, sort of things happened so fast and it reached a point where I came from and where I am right now, it feels like, oh, I've done something.
Yeah.
But it just doesn't feel like I've done enough. You know what I mean? I don't know
now,
where to go.
It's interesting you say that because actually some people might say, and actually some people did say, that Radhika Apte is everywhere. You know, it became that joke that Netflix will, anything that Radhika Apte does, Netflix is happy to kind of be involved. Because at one point you were in Lust Stories,
yes.
You were in Sacred Games, you were in Ghoul, and they were all on the platform at the same time.
Yeah.
Are you constantly working? Have you just been constantly working?
I have. Last 4 years, I've literally only been working and I've not had downtime at all, which is a very good thing.
Right.
And which is why when everybody was like, you're everywhere, it's your year and
correct.
Everything, I was like, it's not my year and I'm not everywhere because it just doesn't feel still that I'm really like enjoying every bit of what is happening. I still feel like, oh, I need to still start, like, you know.
But did you ever worry about spreading yourself too thin when you were working so hard, when there were just releases after releases after releases?
Not really, because see, like, for example, last year's the 1 year I had a lot
lots,
of things.
Yeah. And across platforms.
I had 6 releases last year. But things were shot way before, like Ghoul was shot 3 years ago. Or, do you know what I mean? So
yeah.
you don't anticipate that it's when all going to release in this at the same time,
right.
Basically.
Right. You know, again, it's interesting what you said about not feeling entirely satisfied because I read this interview that you did last year. I think it was right after Padman or it was before Padman. You said you don't feel like a success story. You don't feel like you're successful because you have a different dream. What is that dream?
Being very happy about the work and being very excited. Okay, let's say this. I just feel, okay, this is gonna sound really bad, but I was watching The Favourite.
Mm-hmm.
We were discussing The Favourite,
yeah.
In London,
uh-huh.
In December. The three, like, phenomenal actresses. You know, you have Rachel Weisz, Emma Stone, and Olivia Colman,
yeah.
One of my favourite. And you see, and you know, you talk about female actresses and you look at their careers. The amount of good work that they've done, the amount of roles that they've done in their lives, even an Emma Stone, is incredible.
Right.
And please look at our industry and tell me which actress in the last decade you can say that, look at all these roles she's done, phenomenal work.
Mm.
Because you don't get so much work. There isn't so much work for actresses, where for actors there is. Now, I'm not being this thing saying, oh, we're not getting enough work. It's true. You don't have as much. Tell me, in the last 2 decades, even if you have some really phenomenal actresses have done some great work, it's a one-off. It's like 2 roles in their lifetime. but consistently, right. every like getting really good work mm. and matching the standard of work, not because of their capacities, but the kind of work they're being offered.
Right.
It's just not enough.
It's ironic this is coming from, you know, one of the most exciting actresses, actually. I mean, if you're saying that.
But it's true, isn't it, Rajeev?
I hear what you're saying, but do you feel like, it's gotten better from where we were, say, a few years ago? Because I feel like if you do compare to the West, then you're setting yourself up for disappointment. Mm. Do you feel it's better than maybe... Look, the truth is, you've been working for about 10 years, which a lot of people don't necessarily know.
Yeah.
I mean, Antahin and all came out like 2009.
Oh, yeah.
Is it fair to say 2015 was the breakout year? That was the year that Badlapur happened. It's the year that Hunter happened.
Yes.
And then Ahilya, the short film that you made, all came in the same year.
Oh, did it?
It did.
Yeah, okay.
And that Ahilya was also interesting because it was a completely different way to...
Yeah, but it changed everything.
Sujoy Ghosh used you, correct?
It's so funny. Yeah.
So, do you feel like it's better today than it was when you started?
See, I'll tell you what. It is definitely better. Things are changing. We can't be satisfied with
You're
the
right.
fact that,
I'm
you know
I'm so
what,
glad to hear that. Thank
you. Know what
you.
I mean?
Yeah.
That,
yeah.
You know what? Things are changing.
Correct.
Every year they change. Yeah. Change is the only thing that is constant.
True.
So, of course, it'll change. But today you live in a world where you get to watch everything.
Yeah.
You're traveling all the time.
Correct.
You have to find a way of... And it's not just the responsibility of the film industry because, you know, the society and the industry, it's like obviously a part of each other and also have to work together. But we have to go faster, yeah.
Sure.
You know, this is too slow.
Correct. Good to hear that, actually. Has there been a key decision that you've made, a move that you've made, that would qualify as a bold move? What do you think has led directly, perhaps, to where you are today?
Bold move?
I know you did... up and leave and go to England, to London and to study dance. You kind of just got up one day and said, I'm going for a year.
Yeah.
Pretty bold, some people would say.
Yeah,
you know,
I
bang
mean,
in the middle of...
Yeah. I had Shore in the City releasing and Rakshrata releasing and I had quite a few offers that time.
Correct.
I just said no to everything and I left. I think that's in a way bold.
Yeah.
But I don't know where that took me. I mean, I met Benedict, I had a connection with London, and now I live there.
Yeah.
And that has given, that's probably led to Michael Winterbottom. I don't know,
right.
You know what I mean? Like,
correct.
So,
sort of global citizen has made you in that
sense.
Yeah,
it's made me global citizen. I mean, without sounding anything else, but I don't want to be called any Indian this, that, nothing.
Right.
I want to be like a global
citizen of the world,
of the world, no boundaries. I do like that. And, that perspective came and a lot of things changed in me and understanding of other people and other worlds and blah blah blah.
Right.
So that way it changed.
Of all the characters that you've played so far, Radhika, which one according to you has been the closest to you in reality or rather a sort of reflection of your own true personality?
I think every character reflects a part of you in some way or the other because you know you can empathize with all the characters and there's at least one moment in life or some memory of yours that is there
True.
In that character. So it does reflect, I think. But I mean there's some more or less, you know what I mean? Like a bazaar, I would say less. A Padman, I would say less.
Right.
Andhadhun, I'd say medium. Phobia also, I'd say probably medium.
Right.
Love stories, I'd probably say there was a point I was probably there.
Right.
Ish, not entirely.
Okay.
That's Anurag's interpretation.
I mean,
character.
That's why those lines were rolling off your tongue so naturally. You wrote those, right?
All Anurag, though. I have not written the film.
Okay.
Let me clarify this on screen. I haven't.
Well, then you're a fantastic actress because it really felt so real so natural.
I think the confusion was honest because I was like, what am I saying? I'm kidding. But, so I think some are there, half there, not there sort of a thing. But I don't think there's a character which is completely me or very much like me yet, unless I'm forgetting. Yeah, Hunter was quite also like, you know, I mean, I could relate to it more, I think.
Sure.
But not so much again, because certain choices that are very, 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 very important to the character are very alien to me.
To you, sure. All the best. Thank you for entertaining us like you have. These wonderful performances, really breaking the mold, breaking the rules. I feel like it's the bold bunch is exactly where you belong. Thank you so much. Looking forward to lots more.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.